In this YouTube tutorial, I'll show you how to upload a YouTube video step by step in the YouTube studio. Hi, my name is David, and if this is your first time watching my videos and you get value from the content that you watch, kindly consider liking this video and sharing it with your friends so that we can all learn together. The reason why I'm doing this video is because there are some few things that have changed, especially with the subtitling interface or the section where we had to upload a transcript or subtitles for our videos, and also there are checks to check for copyright that you have to put in just to do a self-evaluation if you have any copyright materials in your content. So follow along and I'll show you how it's done. So basically you need to have a YouTube account if you have a Google account, and you're logged in to your YouTube account. So I'm just on the homepage, YouTube homepage, and this particular button here, that's to create a button. You can click on it. And you have different options come up here depending on your channel growth and all that, just either subscribers or whatever. But just click on upload video. Once you click on upload video, you'll get to the interface to upload videos. You can drag and drop a file that is a video file, or you can select a file. So I'll just navigate to a folder with a video I want to upload or use for this particular process. And it's this video, how to export any subtitle into multiple subtitle formats at once using subtitle edit. All I need to do is just drag and drop it inside the upload interface. And by default, the title of the video is going to be picked by the YouTube title section. Now, as the video is uploading, if you have a thumbnail created, then you can upload your thumbnail, write a description, and ensure that everything else is as you'd like it to be. So for example, I can just write a quick description here. In this video, we'll cover how to export any subtitle into multiple subtitle formats at once using subtitle edit. Now you can build up on that and we can just use the suggestions here. You can build on that for this video. We'll use an SRT subtitle format and convert it to over 200 subtitle formats. You can add whatever else you think might add value for this particular video or description, but for now let's just scroll down slightly. And if you have a thumbnail for this, you can add it. I do have a thumbnail, and I create my thumbnails inside Canva just to make things easy. And then I'll just go to the downloads, just select the particular thumbnail for this, how to export, just drag and drop it to the upload thumbnail, export any subtitle SRT into the different formats. It's explanatory. Next up, I'll scroll down and add a playlist, this video to a playlist. So I'll select a playlist, let's say subtitling and captioning, just click on done. And once I click on done, you can adjust anything else that you want here. Just make sure that everything you set here is whatever is required. Now, you'll notice that YouTube is doing some checks down here. It's checking for maybe copyright, and once there's no issue, copyright check complete, no issues found. There's no content that you've taken from anybody else. There's no music from somebody else. So you can just scroll down. It's not made for kids. And then you can click on show more. And once you scroll down, you'll see sections where you can add tags. And then we can say export subtitles into multiple subtitle formats. You can put a comma right after that. That's one tag. And then you can just type in subtitle edit tutorial. We can do SRT subtitle presenter, and you can keep going on and so forth. But for this particular video, let's just say that's all the tags we wanted, because according to YouTube, tags can be useful if content in your video is commonly misspelled. Otherwise, tags play a minimal role in helping viewers find your video. So we can just scroll down, and the next option is or was to add subtitles. Now, this was the section where we would put in our subtitles, but now you can upload or add captions from the video elements step. So this is the video element step. So this particular option has been moved, and this shows that YouTube is paying attention to the subtitles and closed captions interface and all that. So since there's nothing else that I need to do in this particular section, then I'll click on next. Once I click on next, since my channel is monetized, then I'll need to select the monetization option that I want. Now for this video, I'll just turn on the monetization and click on done. Once I click on done, you can set the types of adverts you want for your video. I'll just leave everything as a default and go on to the next. And from this particular section, you now get the option for ad suitability. This was not there before we checked the monetization. Now, ad suitability is the option where you need to select, because YouTube has updated the guidelines to allow for more green, which is more dollar icons, with moderate profanity, adult humor, and then graphic discussions of controversial issues. And then we can just scroll down. Now, the different options here, ad suitability. Does your video content, title, description, or keywords contain any of the following? Why it's important to rate your video, you can check that. And mostly is just to make sure that YouTube monetizes your video if you're in the monetization program. No, my video doesn't have inappropriate language, but from the dropdown, you can select whatever applies to you. My video doesn't have any of these issues. It's just a tutorial video, no adult content, no violence, no shocking content, harmful or dangerous acts, recreational drugs content, hateful or derogatory content, firearms, sensitive events, controversial issues, none of the above. So I'll click on none of the above. And once I click on that, this particular section turns blue. Now it's active for me to actually do this. And basically, this is how you rate your videos. And the eligible revenue sources include ads, YouTube Premium, other avenues like merchandise. Rate your video carefully. Once you submit your rating, you won't be able to change your responses. So just make a note of that. What happens next? Your rating accuracy is high. So we'll monetize your video using your input. If there's a strong sign your input is inaccurate, your monetization status may change. So let's click on submit rating. And once we click on submit rating, the rating is saved. We can click on next so that we can add video elements. Now, as you'll notice, under the video elements, this is a section where we use to add an end screen and cards. As of May 8th, 2021, YouTube has also included the add subtitles tab or section inside here. And subtitles help you reach broader audience by adding subtitles to your video. So we are going to begin by adding subtitles to our video. Just click on add. And for the purposes of this video, there are a couple of options that you can use. So you can either upload a file, auto sync, or manually type. Now for this particular video, I'll actually upload a file. I'll click on upload file. And the option you can choose here is with timing or without timing. So I'll click on without timing, and YouTube will sync your subtitles to your video audio. Processing may take a while. Now the supported file format is .txt. And as you can notice, since my video is in English, then I'll upload a transcript that is in English. So I'll just click on continue and navigate to the downloads folder. That's where I have this particular transcript for that particular video. Click on it, click on open. And once I click on open, you'll notice that the transcript is going to be loaded on this interface. You can edit the timings. Also, you can download the subtitles, clear the text, upload another file, etc. But since there's nothing I would want to do here, I'll just click on save draft. Now I'll save draft and then click on done. Once I click on done, I'll go back to the section where I need to add the end screen and add the cards. You'll see a circle going on here where YouTube will be assigning timings to the transcript that I've just provided as captions. So let us add an end screen. Click on add, And adding end screens is good because this is what happens. If somebody watches your video to the end, then they might want to watch another video. So let's just select this. And I want to do a one video, a one playlist, and a one subscribe. So that means they can either subscribe to my YouTube channel, they can either watch another video, or they can go and watch a playlist that is related to the particular video I have. So we have the first option here. I'll just click on this, and this is for the playlist. And I'll choose the playlist on subtitling and captioning based on the type of video that I'm uploading. And once I do that, by default, YouTube may set video best for viewer, but let's just scroll down and choose a specific video. Let's say I want to show people how to make an alpha substation subtitle file. I'll just click on this particular video, and it's a recent tutorial that I did, and then click on save. Once I click on save, the end screen is added. Now we can add a couple of cards. So I'll just click on add. And from this option, you can select a different type of cards. You can add a video, a playlist, a channel, or a link. Now, basically, I prefer to just add videos for my videos, and that's what I'm going to do. You have about 5 cards that you can add to your videos. So I'll just come in at around the 32nd. Just click here and then click on video. And then let's say we add something like, let's say add subtitle, how to add subtitles to a video using Filmora, and then come up to this particular section, click on card, add a video. We can scroll down slightly. Let's say how to burn in captions to a video, click on that, and then click on this particular section. We can click on card, video, and then we can just search. Let's just write SRT. And I want this particular tutorial on how to create an SRT file. Just click on that. And maybe let's just say 3 cards for this is sufficient because it's just a video that's about 5 minutes. So let's just click on save. And that's the step to add the cards to our YouTube video. So our subtitles are still having the times assigned. So you can just let that be and then click on next. And once you click on next, this is the section where you see the checks. We'll check your video for any issues that may restrict its visibility or monetization. You'll have the opportunity to fix any issues before publishing your video. So copyright, no issues found. That's a tick. Ad suitability, suitable for ads based on your rating. This is based on your rating, and there's a tick. And you see they have a note here, remember. These checks aren't final. Issues may come up in the future that impact your video. So you need to know that. But once you're satisfied, we'll go to the next tab, which is the visibility tab, where you decide whether you want to save or publish. Set your video as a private video. Only you and people you choose can watch your video. Also, you can set your video as unlisted. Anyone with a video link can watch your video. And they have a tip here. Select this setting and wait a couple of hours to see if any monetization or visibility issues are found. Then publish your video. Now you can set that if you wanted to check out if the checking system has picked up any issues or not. If you think everything is okay, you can set the video as public. And everyone can watch your video if they're searching for it, if it's displayed on the homepage. And you can also set the video as an instant premiere, where it gives a countdown of about 2 minutes and then starts premiering, where people can watch with you. You can also schedule a video. Now, if you click the schedule button, you get the option to select a date to make your video public and a time, and also you can check the time zone. So you'll see that it sets out the time zone in my time zone, GMT plus 3. The video will be private before publishing. Now, if you decide to set as premiere, this particular option will show the graphic of this particular video. So if you wanted to bring in more traffic, just have a video or a thumbnail to a video that more or less will evoke the option or emotion of people to want to know what you want to talk about. That is curiosity. But if you put out a video as this for premiere, most people are going to start searching out for this particular video. So I wouldn't recommend that for such a video, but You can also check here, before you publish, check the following. Do kids appear in this video? Make sure you follow our policies to protect minors from harm, exploitation, bullying, and violations of labor law. Looking for overall content guidance, you can always check the community guidelines, can help you avoid trouble and ensure that your YouTube remains a safe and vibrant community. So that's all you need to do for now. We can just scroll up slightly, come back to the save and publish. Now, if you're satisfied with your results, you can just publish the video to the public, copy the link, share with your fellow creators or your tribe or your community, whatever you want. But that's basically how you upload a video in the YouTube studio using the new different options for ad suitability and checks, and also the new video element of adding subtitles. Now, it seems YouTube is taking some time to assign the timings to my captions, so I will not publish this particular video. I'll let it remain as it is, and by default, you'll see that it has been saved as a draft as we were going on along the way. So all I need to do now, since I don't want to publish this particular video, I'll actually not click on save. I'll just close this out. And once we are taken back to the content area, you'll see that this particular video is a draft. So that's how you can upload a YouTube video in the YouTube studio, step by step, ensuring that you tick all the ticks that need to be ticked. My name is David. I hope this video will help you upload a video successfully. Thanks for watching.